So when we're looking around on the internet, sometimes we can come across PDF documents and we'd like to save them. If you're on the iPhone and the iPad, it's not as easy as just doing a save as or dragging and dropping them out. You need a place to put them, and there's several different places you can put PDFs on your iPad or your iPhone. So let's use the iPad here as an example. And let's say you're browsing the web and you come across a PDF like this one. Now you could just bookmark this page and revisit it each time, but that means it needs to reload the page. It would be nice, since this is a fairly long document, to be able to save it so you just have a copy of it on your iPad. So let's go to the top here and use the share button to save it. One of the ways you can save it is to save it to iBooks. Since iBooks handles documents like PDFs, it would be nice to just have a copy there. So if you look through the options, you can see that one of them here is copy to iBooks. It's right there in the first row with the colored icon. So let's tap that and it's going to save a copy and open up iBooks. So now it's in iBooks and we can get to it. And iBooks is nice because now we can annotate it and do all sorts of things with it. And if you're using iCloud, you'll have this PDF then on all your devices as well. And you can look. You can set up iBooks to just show you all your books or just the PDFs, so you can see just the ones that you've saved. So you can see I've saved a bunch of things here. I've got a bike map. I've got some chapters from different PDF books. I've got even an airport map there. Things that I thought would be handy to have on my iPhone and iPad, I've saved to iBooks, and I have easy access to them even when I'm offline. Now, if you want to instead put it somewhere else, like for instance, let's go back to Safari here and I'm going to hit the share button again, and instead of putting it in iBooks, I'm going to hit save to files, and this will save it to the files app and put it in your iCloud drive space. It actually gives you options here. So for instance, there's the documents app, which I have installed, which allows you to save things there. There's saving it just on my iPad or iCloud Drive. And if you have other services configured like Dropbox or Box.net, things like that, that'll appear here as well. So let's save it to iCloud Drive, and I can just put it in this folder here, just the main folder there. Hit add, and that saves it out. Now if I switch to my Files app, I can see it added it there. There it is, Constitution. And I can tap on it and actually view it inside of the Files app. So this is kind of a viewer that appears in various places, and you can see it's got pages on the right. You can still actually even do annotations a bit in here, at least markup. So it's a nice place to be able to put things. I can put folders and arrange things as I would say on the Finder on the Mac. So there are two great places to save PDFs right from the web. One is to save them to iBooks, and the other is to save them to the Files app to, say, iCloud Drive or just a local file on that one device.